Hello everybody and welcome to Baldur's Gate 3, the latest RPG from Larian Studios, released on Early Access today on Steam, and I'm very excited for this game, the kind of like successor to Divinity Original Sin 2. We're going to play as an Eldritch Knight in this playthrough, so fighter and then specialization for Eldritch Knight, so a fighter using all types of weapons with magic as well. Definitely the style that I like to choose. Of course, there are lots of ways to play this game. This is only the first one that we are going to choose for this playthrough. I hope you're going to enjoy this one. Let's start with the character. And here we are now in the character creation screen. As we can see, we got lots of things here that we can choose. So first of all, my character is going to be named Valken Delaney. We also have to choose a background once again. So we can choose between the criminal, for example, the entertainer, the folk hero, guild artisan, the noble, the hermit, and the outlander. Well, I'm going with the noble in this case because I think it does fit the class that I want to play, and I'm going to play as the fighter for the Eldritch Knight. We do need to choose the fighter, and later on we have then the specialization for it. Next, we do have to choose, well, how do we want to look? I'm going to be a human. Don't call me boring, please. Humans are still fun to play. And also, we need to have a face, of course, a decent one that kind of like fits. This is a nice face. We also have an option between, I think, around 30 skin tones, more than 30. As we can see, so we have lots of options here available for this. Also, the eye color. I tend to normally go with characters that look a bit similar to me, so this is a huge fault on my part. I hate myself for that, but well, this is how things go, so let's just choose a character that looks similar to me. And here we are. This is looking exactly like I do look actually in real life, kind of. And yeah, what we still need to choose now, the class I've already chosen, the fighter, and of course we also have to choose some proficiencies. By default I have the history proficiency. I do need to choose two others, and I'm going with perception. So perception is how your senses work together, detecting the details of your environment and anything out of the ordinary. And survival, survival is knowledge of tracking, foraging and hunting, and familiarity with natural hazards. Since we're going with the Eldritch Knight, also using a bit of magic there, history is a really good skill that we also have along the way. And this is, ladies and gentlemen, our character Valken Delaney, and with him we're going to enjoy a beautiful grand new adventure. Wish you fun, see you on the other side.
Thank you.
Alright, and here we are now, landed in the middle of that after this epic intro. And as we can see, there we have him, Valkandalini. We are really just a green boy at the moment, nothing that we can do. And well, first things first, let's check our surroundings. We first of all are in the middle of a fire, so I think it's the best idea to get out of here. There's a Mind Flayer pot that we could use.
Still be stuck inside if we hadn't been attacked.
Alright, this is where we're coming out from after this attack there. And let's just walk around real quick here and explore the whole thing. As we can see here, we have our actions. So we do have our main hand attack dealing a bit of damage, then the cleave attack, the ranged attack. That's right, we also have a ranged attack with a bow, and then also a pin down effect. Other than that, I like the interface so far, clean and easy to read. And well, we have, do we have an option at the moment or something that we need to do? Enter the turn-based mode. Nope, that's not it. I guess we have to find a way out of here.
The pool that thing came from. The parasite now writhing behind your eye.
Alright, reach towards the pool or investigate it. Let's investigate it first, and we have to roll 1d20. Let's see, there's an intelligence check that we have. Let's roll if we can do this. Oh, very good.
The casing is fragile. The slightest touch could cause it to crumble. Its casing crumbles beneath your hands, sloshing volatile brine as it collapses.
I'm not looking too happy about this. Alright, and it exploded. Lucky we didn't lose any, well, health with that. There are also some people, the Mind Flayer, lying on the ground there. Let's check him real quick. He's got a few things here. Void Bulb that we can throw. And also a Potion of Healing that we can definitely need. And as we can see, we do have three of that right now. We also have a Scroll of Revivify. And we have a Second Wind, which is a special ability for the fighter. Draw on your stamina to protect yourself. We can use this once per day. And it's healing us a bit if we are low. Now, there is a Mind Flayer pot. Another one. Let's just check this. Oh, someone else got out. We're not the only ones. Another Mind Flayer pot. Only pots that we have here in our surrounding. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that we just need to get up here then. Restoration.
Odd. I feel better.
This is where we can actually get through. Oh, beautiful. Certainly looks like it. Right, I guess we should check this out. Whoever that is.
The exposed brain quivers in expectation.
Please. Before they return!
They return.
Who am I talking to? A main or a brain?
A newborn.
Born new from this husk.
You realize you're talking to an intellect devourer. A minion of the Mind Flayers who abducted you.
I think you're past the point of saving. Tell me what to do. Or you sound afraid. Why?
So many enemies.
Alright, we have to destroy it. Oh, I think you're past point of saving. Tell me what to do.
Remove us
from this body.
From this case. Free us.
Alright, we can now go within, because we have these skills here, and we can also see that, well, plus 3 from, for example, strength would be a good idea, or dexterity, gently prize the brain from the skull. Let's try this. And let's roll. I like this already. And successful. Oh god, no.
The brain lifts from the skull. But you notice an opportunity. You could cripple the strange creature, making it more subservient should it prove a threat.
Okay, mutilate the brain or spare the creature. Yeah, let's spare it. I don't know, we're not that cruel, right? Oh god, I am having a brain in my hands.
We are free. Our freedom is ours, friend.
The creature pauses, listening. Something behind your eyes seizes in recognition.
We must go to the helm.
At the helm, we are needed.
What's at the helm?
Tenses, as though querying an unseen advisor.
Do you not hear it? We will not survive
here. We are needed to
navigate.
We are needed to leave
this realm.
All right, let's go.
To the helm we go.
We are going to the helm.
Let's hope that this is a good thing, right? Perhaps he's got some loot there as well. Nope, this was really a naked guy without anything, without any possessions. And thus, well, a bit fearful perhaps, a bit skeptical we continue on the journey here. Finding a way out. Let's go down here again. Is the creature following me? I hope it can follow me. There seems to be an exit. Oh, and now we're really outside. We're still in the air and flying around. The dragons are still chasing us. And we need to jump over there in order to get up there. And jump we do. Very good. The brain, is it following us? No, it's not following us. I hope the brain still can keep up. And I like the graphics already. Look at that. Beautiful. Oh, and I know her.
This is your end.
Your head throbs and your skin tingles. Visions rush past. A dragon's wing, a silver sword, and a flash of your face seen through the strange woman's eyes.
Oh, my head. What is this? Blesses me this day. Together, we might survive. Imps block the path forward. You will assist me in destroying them. We must reach the helm before we transform.
Transform? What do you mean?
We carry Mind Flayer parasites. Unless we escape, unless we are cleansed, our bodies and minds will be tainted and twisted. Within days, we will be Geich, Mind Flayers.
We are turning into Mind Flayers. There must be something we can do. Well, she said that already. Is the helm our way out of here?
It is where we might gain control of the Ga'ath, the ship. Once in command.
Okay, that's the helm.
Alright,
onward
first,
then.
We exterminate the imps. Then we find the helm and take control of the ship. We will address the matter of a cure for this infection once we reach the material plane.
Alright, I think we got our first companion. Yep, and we got the brain there as well. I don't see it yet, but perhaps in battle it will appear. I have a feeling that we are close to the first battle now. And we also get the combat tutorial because of that. So, combat happens in turns, and we have a turn order, which is then decided with dice. And your available actions are highlighted here. Bonus actions are reactions you can perform on top of your normal actions. And the movement bar shows how much distance you can cover during your turn. Alright, so we can cover 9 meters. This is our attack here that we have, and these are the bonus attacks. So we are hurt right now. I totally don't know. Laesel, she is called. And let's just have a look around. Where are the enemies? We have 1, 2, 3 imps, what I can see. And what is she actually? Is she... I think she's a fighter too. Yes, she is a fighter as well. So she's got basically the same abilities we have. And of course, getting close into the combat is a good thing. Let's jump in there and let's just see. There, we did it. And get a bit closer there. And I'm pretty sure that we can use the surroundings again, just like last time. And let's just try to have a range attack. Very good. 85% chance. We can do this. and this imp has been damaged because of that. And this is... Oh, opportunity attack. Automatically attack one creature moving out of your reach. This is a reaction. Reactions happen outside of your turn. Alright, so this is not something we can do right now. And now we are choosing... Oh, we are, well, switching to Valken. Let's just have a look. You can also move forward here. And... perhaps I should not get too close to her there as well. But the jump is not available anymore. Let's get a bit back again and use the range attack. 90% chance. Very good. Where is the brain now? That's the big question. The brain is not here. Alright, no one of them is doing anything. So it's our turn again. Let's get closer to her. We still have... we have 9 meters, so we can get as close as possible, actually. And most likely attacking with our main hand. Right, this was that. Dip, code your weapon in your surface to deal additional damage, push a target away, shoving unsuspected targets, and hide. None of these we would like. Perhaps dip, perhaps that is doing something. Nope, it's not. Alright, we're going with Valken right away. Let's see. Could we get close to this creature there? I think we might reach it. Let's try to range attack this fella over here. Righto. And then we can jump over here and perhaps, just perhaps, attack it still. But nope, that is not possible. It's too far away. All right, it's their turn. And we're taking a bit of damage here, as we can see. But in that case, we also have the second wind bonus action available as a fighter. So that is always something we can use. Let's kill this creature. Gaining us a bit of experience points there. And then we are most likely... we could also go with hiding. Stick to the shadows to improve your chances of going undetected. Or I'm going to activate my second wind. This is exactly what I'm doing. And thus we can heal a bit here, as we can see. Now it's back to Valken. Let's... I think we can go for this creature right away. We don't have that many actions yet. Oh, that was a one-shot. Very nice. And thus we have killed all the imps. One with the range, one with melee, and she did one with the melee. Let's just see what they got. A bit of gold, a scroll of mage armor, surround a creature in a protective magical force. Its armor class increases by 3. Not a bad thing, I guess. This creature has nothing. And then we still have something over here. Oh, there's also a mind flayer. Another void bulb and a spiked bulb. A sticky, sap-like substance trickles down the spikes of this bulb. I could probably use it then in battle. Oh, a longsword! Our first weapon. Is it an improvement, though? It is 1d8 slashing. One-handed. We could use it as a one-handed weapon or a two-handed weapon. But I think other than that, it's pretty much the same. It also has the cleave weapon special ability. Right, how good that there is also restoration, that we can restore ourselves right away. And let's continue up the stairs it is to, I think now, to the helm. Oh, I hope we're not on board of that platform. But it seems all is fine. At least the dragon doesn't seem to be too hostile. Alright, there's something over there, a glass cannon. Oh, I think we'll need to continue further up there. Well, we still fly at staggering speeds. Alright, there is another thing here. Wounded imps. Is that the combat right away? I think it is. We can actually go to that imp right away since they're both together there. I think we might also cleave. Can we cleave? Oh. Alright, we can only cleave in our direct range, it seems. So we'll actually need to go in there. Commence the battle. I've used the cleave now, so I cannot use it again, otherwise I would have done it. But, as we can see, easy target, was already pretty damaged. This one here though we cannot do at the moment. So that import is doing. It missed us with a fireball. Let's just see. It's a bit further there, I hope. Can we jump over there? Yes, because I want to jump over the fire right into him and let's slash him. Also, one shot. Pretty good. Anything in store? Bit of gold again. A candle takes additional fire damage for the duration. And the imp, perhaps. There's a student lying around.
I'm a bit peaked, Mom. I think I'll go to bed early.
The Mind Flayers have already enthralled him. Leave him, or we will share his fate.
Alright, he left to die, unfortunately, poor soul. There's still something, a thrall. Perhaps he's got something. A bit of gold and a quill. Let's not try to get into the flames there. Mucus membrane we have in front of us. I think we need to shoot that. Or hit it. Very good. Valken seems to know what he's doing. And we're once again inside the beast. And this looks like the hell.
Mystic, back. Touch nothing without knowing its purpose.
Someone is speaking from that pot.
Get me out of this damn thing!
We have no time for stragglers.
There's magic at work here, but what kind? Oh, target is only 7. Should be fine for us. And we rolled a 17.
Warding runes. The pod won't open unless they're destroyed.
Alright, some runes. Try to disrupt the bright lights. Let's just have a look where we... No, I'm not leaving you for good. I'm just trying to find the runes that we can destroy then. There is something there. A chest. Oh, it's locked. Right, we do need a key for that. I think in order to get her out, either there is a tank here. Perhaps we need to do... Can we do that? Oh, no. I think that wasn't a good idea.
Come on! Get me out of this thing!
Where are the runes, though? There's magic. Oh, look for a latch that might open the lid.
Is too alien. Nothing looks familiar.
No, we already know it's the runes.
Do you intend to die for a stranger?
Try to disrupt the bright lines of magic with a touch. Oh god.
Are you satisfied? We need to go.
No. Wait. Let's try and find the runes. If there are scattered around here, we might do something about it. But for now, she'll have to wait. There's a backpack. And some gold again, very good. Let's continue. Another Mind Flayer pot.
How many hosts of these gay infect?
A dazed woman is trapped inside the pod. She doesn't notice you.
Use jump to reach. What? No, I can get up there. Drink cleric. Oh, he's got the key and some gold. And a mugwort bundle. A bane of farmers and gardeners. This quick growing weed reappears mere days after being cut. Right, there's nothing here. Certainly looks interesting though. There's something. I'm not looking too happy. Or Valken, I should say. Oh god, what is happening to her? put on a makeup of some kind.
Changed at the pull of a lever. How? If we are not purified, this may be our fate.
Alright, we really need to get rid of these parasites inside of us. We got a key at least. Let's get back. And hope for the best. My brain is running around here as well. My little pet brain. And there is the reliquary. Yes, onyx. Alright. And a bit of gold once again, but that's it. There's a brain jar. Certainly don't need that. Bit of restoration. We still haven't freed her. Alright, there's a battle. Some thralls. Oh, and they put us into an exit there right away. Let's get out there. And we can direct. Yep, very good. That was easy. This one we cannot reach for now. Let's switch back to Valken. I don't want to stay too close though, just in case she has this exit again. So we might just stay over here, far away, and hit her with a ranged attack. Very good. Took quite a lot of damage there. And this one is actually attacking with his fists. Why are you doing this? Oh, I see. We missed. That was an opportunity strike, most likely. Let's try this. Right, we don't have enough action for that. It's 75%, 80% chance. Very good. Down you go. A bit of gold, a small bottle. And a copper ring. Looks not too worthy. Right. Doesn't seem like anything else though here. We can, of course, heal ourselves once again. And then most likely, yeah, take this route here that we still have available to us. Perhaps it's a good idea to destroy it. Okay, nothing happens there. There's just some restoration here.
They're nearing the helm. Once inside, do as I say.
Will do. Wait a second. This is where we came from, right? I'm a bit confused right now. Everything looks the same in this little ship. There we need to go. We can see it on the map as well. The helm is in front of us. Battle, there it is once again. We have our first little boss, Commander Salk. Few imps on the way.
We need to get
and
out.
Once again,
now.
Missed. So let's just see what we can do. Either we go in close. I mean, we are fighters after all, so close combat is our specialty. I don't think that I will be... Nope, I'm not going to be able to get too close there. So let's just try and hit her. Imp there with a bow. With a bow, I said. Alright, she doesn't want to hit him with a bow. I think it actually... Yeah, she cleaved now, but I definitely choose the ranged attack. Or did I really miss? Who knows? I mean, they're really bad at aiming. None of them hits me. Okay, it's her once again. This time, though, this guy here is a bit closer. Let's sneak up on him. That was a critical hit, actually. And let's move over here. Right. And then I would like to have Valken there as well. She'll over for her. And Valken will hit with a ranged attack. Very good. First one is out. Let's get a bit closer now to the other ones there. Commander Salk. He's still fighting. The imps are desperately trying to hit us. It's incredible, really.
If this ship hits the ground, we're dead.
Let's focus another one down. This guy here. He's far away though. Let's try it ranged again. This time it works. Range is not so strong, of course. We might try and hide behind a pillar here. So perhaps this imp doesn't reach us. Let's get a bit closer there as well. 90% is fine. And down the next imp is. Very good. Did not expect anything else. Let's just see. How far can we jump? If I go here or here, can I jump to this one? Ah, I can actually do this. But I'm doing this with Valken. He's much stronger. Oh, critical miss. That's bad. And jump. Just because I like this ability so much. And main hand attack. Down it is with one slash. Alright, we're still in battle. Can we reach anyone there? Commander Salk, 30% chance. I was missed, of course. Alright, but Valken will be able to hit. Or not. 35% chance. Ah, missed again. I think we need to get in close here. Oh, okay, we actually don't even need to go for him. We just need to go with the for the transponder. Right, but where is the transponder? There it is. Valken, you still have some movement points. Let's rush towards it.
It's clear. Hurry before they strike.
More imps on the way. Can we reach this one? No, we cannot reach it. Alright. Okay, now they're hitting me. They've been missing so far, but now all of a sudden it's possible for them. Perhaps we can jump there and slash. Let's try this. I would really like to use slash, but it's not working. Okay. Alright, but with Valken it's going to work. Very good. One has been taken out. That was nice. Oh, and there are more coming from behind as well. It will be a good idea now to use some of my items, I think. Alright, this one only has 1 HP. It seems like a waste to really... Oh, this is interesting. We have a special ability here, the Psychonics. The Mage Hand create an invisible spectral hand that can manipulate and interact with objects. Let's try this one. Right, I guess I need to use it on an object then. Mind Flayer, can we do that? I guess not. Not for now, at least. We can still move, though. Up to the transponder. With Valken, well, we only have really the option. First of all, can we damage this one with a Void Bulb or a Spike Bulb? No, cannot do that. Can only hit him. Oh, he's still holding up there. Well, they are coming closer, the Cambians. Okay, we're pretty close to the transponder now. I think we might actually... Can we jump to the transponder? We can't do this. And touch it.
The Helm's alien transponder. You've made it in time.
It seems like that's it. And I hope we get getting finally off this ship. Not a beautiful environment. This one looks much nicer. I guess they don't need any words to communicate. Oh boy, right on the head. Yes, someone saved us, and thus we are finally on firm ground again, and here we're going to continue the next episode. Stay tuned.